So, you want to talk about some big mods? Yeah, I got some big mods. All right, what's up, everybody? GrimmGreen back here today. Thank you so much for joining me. Today, we're going to be taking a look, like I said, some big mods. Now, these monster Lipo battery pack powered mods come from DefMods. That's their little logo there. That's their little logo there. They also do a mini version of these Lipo powered mods. Use some heavy air quotes there on the mini because the mini is still a pretty big brick. I feel like we don't need to go uppy-closey, but I still want to do a quick short uppy-closey time for these. I'll have some links down in the description, but we're going to do some up close. We're going to come back here. We'll do some pros and cons and some final thoughts on these. Boosh. Boosh. So this is my original DefMods that he sent me where they did all the custom graphics. It's got, you know, evil stuff all over it. Little Grimm army right there. DNA 250C right there. Clicky MyTech. Micro USB for charging. But this panel comes off and you can see your LiPo on the inside. It's just a beast. It's just a car battery. Now this is the custom Guar one that they did for me. This is the mini. Again, this panel comes off. You can see your LiPo on the inside. And it's branded. Magnets, DNA 250C, micro USB. This one has a lighty up sort of button on there, about 4.2 inches tall, almost 2 inches across, and it's a square. They look bigger on camera. It's honestly not that huge. At least the mini's not that huge once you get it in your hand. Now, every graphic they do is a one-off graphic. You provide them with a 1080p wallpaper to kind of wrap around it, and they'll do it for you. You can hire their graphic guy to design it, to like help you design it, but that costs extra. These are all one of a kind, one off, and unique. They never repeat the same graphic for any two mods. And so this is just the fucking Guar nightmare custom mod. My calipers don't even go this big, so it's a little bigger than 5 inches long. What do we got this way? 1.6 inches. What do we got this way? 2.3 inches. The big guy, it's huge. This is actually bigger than it looks on camera. They also customize their DNA 250Cs with a big graphic behind it. So sometimes it can be, I don't know, a little bit messy, like a little bit jumbled on here, but you can still see what you need to see. 83 watts, your resistance, your voltage, your amperage. You can change all this like you would. Battery level indicator up there as well. And I mean, even looking at this custom Guar job they did for me, it's bright and crisp and nice. All the graphics look very sharp, you know, there's no pixelation. You can tell this isn't just some blown up image on here. But anyway, yeah, that's really all there is to these. Let's get back out to normal view and let's vape them. Lots of power, lots of battery life. Those are going to be the two first pros from me. Now, a lot of these pros and cons are going to be subjective pros and cons. If you aren't objectively interested in these, then you're probably just not going to be interested in these. In my opinion, it's kind of a niche within an already niche market. I like big LiPo powered big box mods. They feel real vintage to me, real retro, kind of throwbacky back to a time when it was just people modding boxes to literally make our vape gear. Once upon a time, we didn't have big companies like Vaporesso or Smoke or Voopoo cranking out, you know, dual 18650 box mods. Kind of had to make them ourselves. And that's really what this reminds me of. A big pro for me with these is gonna be just the crispy graphics on them. So as I was saying, these are unique and one of a kind, and one that you have, no one else will have. And so sure, they did this custom crazy ass Guar wrap for me because Guar is one of my favorite bands of all time. I do see a difference between doing this and maybe mass producing something with this much copyright infringement on it. They're not making 1,000 Guar mods and selling 1,000 Guar mods. They made one custom just for me. I see no real difference between this and putting a custom wrap on your already existing mod. And still talking about the graphics, I don't know what process they use to put these graphics on here, but these in no way feel cheap or like a sticker at all. It's very seamless. Even where the door meets up, you can't even really see the seam of the door in the graphic. It's just very well put on here. And the same thing kind of goes for the graphics on the big one too. You can see this door stripe right here. It doesn't really, like when you pull this off, it doesn't affect the graphics. They still all line up perfectly. Now, this wasn't exactly my doing. They just said, you want to put a bunch of evil stuff on a mod? And I said, yeah, sure, let's do that. Another big pro for me is I like both of the buttons that they used on this. This one is sort of a clicky horn light up style button. This is a really clicky MyTech switch. Now these come in sort of different configurations, but what I believe I have in my hand right here is the 300 watt 3S 4000 milliamp hour LiPo powered box mod. It doesn't have a name, you know, it's just the LiPo powered box. It's not like the Vaporesso Gen. And this is the mini 300 watt 1800 3S LiPo pack powered box mod. I just like them. I can't help it, but there are some cons. On the mini, yeah, there's some door play, sort of up and down, side to side. You kind of hear it clicking around. On this full size 4000 mod guy, nothing. The door's perfectly good, perfectly fine, no play anywhere. But on the big version, I think this MyTech switch is going bad, which I'm sure I could send this back to them for repairs. But occasionally when I'm vaping this, I feel like I have to press that MyTech switch a little bit harder than normal in order to get it to fire. Another con for me, and this is just the limitations of the DNA250C, it's a micro USB charging, and on the mini, in fact, on both of these models, I've had issues charging them. I don't think it's an issue on my end because I've tried a bunch of different micro USB cables, but it has to be in there kind of just right, and you kind of have to do that thing where you pull it up, you know, you push it up a little bit and then wong, and then it'll start charging. It doesn't make a wong sound. That's just my futuristic, you know, Apple like wong sounds. But you kind of got to fiddle with it and get it in the right position to let it charge. But other than like those few small things, these work as they are intended to work. They're giant LiPo powered box mods for the 20th time. Okay, so some final thoughts on these. These really do bring me back to a time when it was just some people making mods, one at a time, custom LiPo box mods. These to me are like the spirit of like the hobbyist vape industry. Sure, they're big, and sure, they're heavy, and sure, these are not going to appeal to a large group of people. But to those people that this does appeal to, and you're into like custom-made LiPo-powered DNA250C boxes, you're gonna dig this. I'm thankfully one of those people. I came from the, you know, MVP generation of vapers where all I carried around with me was a little LiPo-powered box mod. People do sometimes get a little bit weird or intimidated by LiPo-powered things, but as long as you're careful and you treat your mods and batteries with the respect that they deserve, then you shouldn't have any problems. Standard battery safety etiquette and rules still apply with LiPo-powered 3S packs. Don't puncture them because that will lead to some sort of super catastrophic battery failure. So just be careful, be smart with your batteries.
So let's we hand out some banana stickers.
I truly do love these things. They've become just my reliable bangers that I use for vaping, that I use for fiddling. If I'm building an RDA or building an RTA, I have a great platform right here with plenty of battery life and plenty of power included. And rather than rate them separately, I'm just gonna rate them together as like a DefMods package for banana stickers. They're not flawless, but they're pretty great. And I wish the screen was a little cleaner. I didn't mention this in the cons because it's a DNA250 and you can kind of customize it however you want, but it comes customized from DefMods with a very loud, borderline like difficult to see display. So, vape budget hands, you gonna need them? Maybe. Depending on the configuration you want, the mini with the 1800 milliamp hour LiPo pack on the inside starts at about $280, and it can go all the way up to $325, $340 for the larger, you know, bigger capacity LiPos, higher wattage box mods. So yeah, I feel like there's some pretty serious vape budget hands in there. Now, if we're gonna play the aliens game or the FDA game where they come to my house, they take all my vape gear and I have nothing left to vape, is a DefMods box mod something I'm gonna seek out and buy right away? Here's the thing. I don't want to be without these. I truly and honestly love them a lot, and they get a lot of use. If I had to pick just one to use, I'd probably go with the mini size. Nothing against this, it's just a little bit too big to be realistic. This is like a desk mod at best. You're not taking this and a dripper in the car with you when you go to Trader Joe's. You're just not. But I dig this mini one. I dig the power it gives me. I dig the battery life. I dig the custom graphics that are just on my mod. So yeah, I'd have to save up my vape budget hands and finally break down and pop for a custom Guar DefMods.
Yeah. 30 millimeter atomizers on this mini, no big deal. Forgot to mention it, it's no big deal.
Anyway, that's enough rambling for me. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. Links are not allowed in the description, so you're gonna have to use your Google Foo, or as always, thank you so much for watching, everybody. Remember, no matter what anybody tells you, vaping is at least 95% less harmful than burning deadly combustible tobacco cigarettes. So yeah, man, no matter what's in your hand, absolutely, you guys, let's keep on vaping.